Hello everyone, this is Professor Yashoda, Department of Physics, Cambridge Institute of Technology. Today, we take one more experiment on photodiode. So, the aim of the experiment is determine the IV characteristics of a given photodiode. So, the IV characteristics means the current voltage characteristics of a given photodiode. So, the apparatus required for this experiment is like 0 to 5 volt regulated power supply, 0 to 5 milliampere digital DC current meter, and 0 to 20 volts digital DC voltmeter, and LED, white light LED, and gallium arsenide photodiode LED type. So by using this apparatus, we are going to find the IV characteristics of this photodiode, and also we calculate the reverse resistance of this photodiode. So let us take the apparatus. And this is the ready-made kit. Kit consists of an apparatus, whatever required for this experiment. So this is the voltmeter and this is milliammeter. And this is the voltage control, the power supply. And this is LED and it is an LED light source. And this is the photodiode. Here the photodiode is placed. And all these apparatus is taken and it is fixed. And now I will going to show the connections for this experiment. Now for this experiment we require a patch cords. So the patch cords are like this and the points also it is represent to connect the patch cords. So you start from the one end of the circuit. So this is the circuital part and the extra apparatus required for this circuit connections it is given here. And I will show you the circuit connection here. So the circuit connection has circuit connection it shows like require resistance IPD and this is photodiode and this is VPD and this is power supply. So we connect IPD to the photodiode and VPD to the battery. So let us take this apparatus and do the connections. So for the connections we require a patch cords. So the patch cords are like this. So the two ends we have to connect it. So the circuit consists of the points are like this. So this point we can insert the patch cord. So this is the battery and we connect a battery positive to the positive of the circuit. So this is the voltmeter connection positive. And the next negative of the voltmeter to the negative of the circuit we have to connect it. So first we have connected the power supply to the circuit. So after this, observe the circuit here. So there is a voltmeter and it is positive end and a negative end. So positive, you connect this voltmeter to the extra voltmeter it is provided. That voltmeter we have connected to the circuit now, positive of the voltmeter. And negative of the voltmeter, connect negative of the voltmeter to the negative of the voltmeter. Next, observe here there is a milliammeter. So milliammeter it is connected horizontally. So the left side milliammeter represents a positive and right side it represents negative. So this is positive, connect positive of the milliammeter to the extra milliammeter it is provided. So positive to positive. And next negative to negative we have to connect it. Then afterwards there is a photodiode here. This is a photodiode. A photodiode has a negative end and a positive end. Connect negative to negative and a positive to positive of the photodiode. This is the photodiode here. So in this photodiode this is the negative. So black color represents here negative and connect negative to negative of the photodiode and similarly positive to the positive of the photodiode. Next connect positive of the photodiode to the positive of the photodiode to the circuit. and this is output for light source. So light source we have to connect here. So this is the light source, LED light source. Connect LED light source, the LED light source. It has two ends here, the negative and the positive. So connect here negative to the negative of the circuit here. And next positive to the positive. Now let us switch it on and we'll take the readings. So this is the switch button. So we have to start with the on here. Switch it on. And we can see the readings in the voltmeter and a milliammeter. So to take the readings, we require a tabular column. Take the readings as increasing the voltage, we have to note down the current readings. So the current we take in milliamperes. So the increasing voltage start from 0 volts, take up to 10 volts. And the current readings correspondingly we have to note down for a distance varying from 1 centimeter to 3 centimeter. So as you keep the LED near to the photodiode, so it detects a more light. And so that the current also increases. It is very high at 1 centimeter. As increasing the distance, the current detection will be very less. So, as you keep the LED source at 1 centimeter, the photodiode will detect a large amount of light. And as increasing the distance, as you keep away this LED source from the photodiode, the LED will incident the light on the photodiode. The photodiode will detect this light incident upon it. So it acts like a detector, the photodiode. So that as increasing the distance, the detection of a light goes on decreases. So first we have to set the intensity of a light, LED light. So as the knob, you can rotate and you can observe here the intensity increasing of this LED source. So we have to fix the intensity. So this is the reference point and this is the knob we use to set the intensity of the LED source as a light. So fix at reference point. Next, keep this LED source at 1 centimeter distance from the photodiode. Then afterwards, close this LED and the photodiode to avoid the light which is falling externally on the photodiode. And let us take the readings now. As increasing the voltage, we have to note down the current. So this is the power supply to increase the voltage. We use this knob to increase the voltage. And correspondingly, we have to note down this current readings. So, start from 0 volts. Start from 0 volts and note down the corresponding current reading is 0. Next, increase the voltage to 1 volt. 1 volt and note down the current reading. So, it is about 1 volt to current reading is 1.73. So let us take the reading. So the voltage we started for 1 centimeter. The voltage for a 0 is, current is 0. For 1 volt we got 1.73 milliamperes. Like this we have to continue as increasing the voltage and we have to note down the current readings. So I will show you the reference readings here. The readings start from 0 volts and note down the corresponding current reading as the distance between LED and a photodiode we have kept at 1 centimeter. So as increasing the voltage, 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, 4 volt like that and the corresponding current we get from the milliammeter like this. So up to 10 volts we have to note down the reading for 1 cm. And similarly, follow the same procedure for the distance between LED and a photodiode to keep at 2 cm. So again, what we have to do, we have to keep the LED light, keep at 2 cm apart from the photodiode, and again close this by using a cloth, and again take the reading as increasing the voltage, note down the current readings. So for 1 volt we are getting 1.30, and again for 2 volts we are getting 1.32, so 3 volts, 1.34, like this we have to increase taking the readings up to 10 volts. And similarly, follow the same procedure for a 3 cm distance between LED and a photodiode. So we get a readings like this. And after this, we have to plot a graph, the voltage versus current, and we get a graph like this. So we have to plot a graph in a third quadrant. So we have to take along x-axis the voltage, and along y-axis we have to take a current. So start from the scale 0, and the voltage starting from 0 to 10. So as it is, you can select the scale 0 to 12. And the scale for current, so minimum 0 and a maximum up to 2.4 it is selected here. So as you plot the graph for the readings, for a 3 columns, for between 1 cm to 3 cm, we get a graph like this. So for a first one, we get a graph like this. We get a points. For a 1 volt, it is about 1.3. So like this, the points we get. And with the free end, we have to join these points. No need of using scale. So like this, take other 2 tabular column readings and we have to plot a graph like this, and we get a graph 2 curves. So by using this curves, and we are going to find the reverse resistance. So to find the reverse resistance, we have to take a slope here. So we know that how to take a slope here. So for 1 curve, it is selected and draw a triangle. And find AB by BC to find the slope value. So AB by BC, if you take, we get V by I, and we want a resistance here. I by V we want to get it, so that R will be equal to 1 by slope. So that R we get approximately 30 kilo ohms. So this is about the reverse resistance of the given photodiode. So by using this photodiodes, we have n number of applications. Like we can use these photodiodes as a photo detector and a photo communicator and switching circuits. Like this, n number of applications are there by using this photodiode.